वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटि समप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा। वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटि समप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा। वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटि समप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा।
Now come to page 58. Now you see the born in 1977. 8 years, 77 to 85. Right? Then 85 to 95. I have taken only 10 years. I have not taken 11 years, though Venice is exalted. The event to be examined is that her mother was quite sick in the middle of 1992. If you calculate the Taurus sub-periods on the basis of 10 years, this falls in Taurus Cancer, 1985. Now go in the backward direction. Mesha 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 into 10 will be 100. 100 means divide by 12. 8 years and 4 months. Right? Add 8 years to 1985. And 10 months. Right? You reach Taurus Cancer. In Cancer, she has Matra Karaka, her mother. The corresponding period in Inshuti Dasha was Mars period and Mercury sub period. Mars in the ninth house, casting the eighth aspect on the Saturn in the fourth house. You can see the trouble to the mother. And Mercury and Mars both in the ninth house. The corresponding curvature. Now see, first see the Vinshuti Dasha. Mars is the lord of the ascendant and the eighth house is with Mercury, the third and the sixth lord. The girl got burnt seriously on August 23rd, 1992. While her mother was ailing. You see, I don't know whether that is there in English or not. In Hindi we say, which literally means, tragedies do not come alone. So one problem, her mother used to come to me. She was very seriously sick and she is the first daughter. She was learning dance very well. Suddenly she got burnt. The girl got burned seriously on August 23rd, 1992, while her mother was ailing. The aspect of Jupiter, the ninth lord, was the basis on which prediction of her recovery was made. But I saw Jupiter in her lagna, and Jupiter aspecting Mars and Mercury. So I said, don't worry, Jupiter is there, she will recover. Now come to Chardasha. In Chardasha, it was Taurus Cancer. From Cancer, three quadrants, Cancer, Libra, Capricorn have malefics. The fourth quadrant Aries has Jupiter but with Ketu. From Cancer, finally, the fifth lord of education goes into the sixth house and is with the 12th lord Mercury. Her education was interrupted for some months. The girl was doing very well. So in India, first of all, you people come and ask you, well, will the education be all right? So I saw some interruption in both ways. She got burnt. I had not said burnt, but I said, well, something will happen, something like an accident. So what the principle I am giving you here is, when you examine whether a Mahadasha or the Antadasha of a Rashi, put your finger on that Rashi and from there you see how planets are placed. Right? So period by period you are able to see, then come to the corresponding Vinshottari Dasha. That is the composite technique. This and this. So here if you put your finger on Kark, who is the fifth lord, going into the sixth house, and the Kark contains Mars, Rahu, Matrikaraka, the mother is sick there. Exactly Matrikaraka, so something representing mother is happening. You are able to catch the event now. I say something about your mother during this period. After this explanation which I am giving you through Gemini, you can request other people in USA who have known me that what Mr. Rao is doing is applying pure astrology. He is not a psychic at all. He is a very normal human being. In one horoscope I saw there somewhere in San Rafael last year, one lady came. I said, what happened when you were a child? She said, what? I said, I see a terrible fire in your father's house and you have to run away. Well, after the reading, she went out and told people, this man, K.N. Rao, is not an astrologer, he is a psychic. How does he know 50 years ago that my father's house was burned down? Now you understand the meaning here? Is it clear to you? When you are tracing, you are seeing Matrikaraka in the fourth house. In Vinshottari, you are seeing Mars, Saturn in the fourth house, aspected by Mars. And the girl is passing through in Vinshottari the dasha of sub-period of Mercury, third and sixth lord of accidents. Mars is involved. Mars is a Lagna lord for her. The body gets involved in accident, but Jupiter is aspecting. It was such a terrible case. The doctors are almost feeling hopeless. I said, no, Jupiter is in the Lagna, Jupiter is aspecting Lagna lord. So, the Mrityunjaya mantra, etc., whatever they do, they went on doing. And slowly the girl recovered and has recovered so well. She is able to go back to her dance lessons and she is doing very well in her studies now. But at that stage, doctors thought it was a hopeless case. And much worse, after all those burns, if she got disfigured, to get married would have been a problem. Think of all those problems. Yes, your question?
Yeah, as far as the sixth lord for accidents, do you take the eighth lord as well?
Pardon?
Do you take both the sixth and the eighth lord for accidents?
Sixth lord generally for accidents. Eighth for suffering which can be prolonged. So I'll skip over to the next question. I'll read it out. Do only two case studies and give you enough chance to abuse me. Right? The first progeny of Lord Brahma, the creator, was known as Manasaputra. Children born through Lord's resolution. But when the first creation started seeking salvation right from the start, the Lord faced a serious problem, which was solved through the advice given by Lord Shiva, that in future creation should be through sex. That is, the original mistake committed by the Creator was, through Sankalpa, through his resolution he created. So everyone was born directly through the Sankalpa, and people came and started straight away striving for salvation. So Lord Brahma discovered that the human race would not continue at this race. If everyone would come and seek salvation, go away, what would happen to the world? How would they continue? So this is a serious mistake. How do I overcome it? Then Lord Shiva, there is an Akashvani, there is a direction, and Lord Shiva appeared before him in the shape of Ardhanarishwara, half male and half female. And when Lord Shiva stood before him, from between his eyebrows a power was released and entered Brahma. Then Brahma decided that the creation had to have the male and had to have the female. And the mutual attraction between them has to be there through sex, so that one ties the other down. And unless you are tied down, human race cannot continue. So now Brahma can rest and ask you to keep on producing your children. Otherwise, his problem in the first creation was, every time he had to replenish the stock. Now, no problems. You do that yourself. So that was the first one. Since then, sex has become an adorable, artistic, enjoyable, joy-giving acts of humans under ideal conditions, and a pure act of carnality, brutality and criminality under the others. You agree with this statement? Right? So sex can be very uplifting in some cases. The questions they ask. In traditional societies, parents of children, particularly of daughters, ask when their daughters would get married. In USA and England, it becomes a question about relationship. Now, with homosexuality getting legalized, astrologers face an order question: male, male or female, female compatibility for the purpose of marriage or relationship. A terrible problem in one place last year. One person came to me and said, will you match the horoscope? I said, I don't do it. He said, but I want you to look into this. I said, you are asking for individual this. First of all, I don't do much of matching of horoscopes, and it needs a new type of research. Then I said, but I saw the name, suddenly there was a male name, and he was a male. I said, what do you mean by matching? Then he told me, now male-male matching is a new phenomenon. You see, total I go away from tradition. Normally matching in India means male-female. He said, do it. I said, for God's sake, please leave me alone. But you are going to face this problem. That's your challenge, not my challenge. Try to understand. Right? And in another case, I had the same problem with a female, lesbians. Do the matching. I said, no, I can't do that. I really don't know. So it's a new thing which is coming into play. But it can work, perhaps, if you work on it. But I don't know whether there is a marriage of lesbians or homosexuals. I don't know. Is there any legal marriage? Huh? I see. Anyway, now some parameters in Gemini I'm giving you. These are all tested parameters of mine. Note down, among the researchers I have produced in Gemini astrology, this had to receive serious attention. I then formulated some parameters which have worked well in a very large percentage of cases. Note down the following. One, the ascendant and the seventh lord, seventh house. Now these are the axes, A-X-I-S, 1-7, 1-7, 1-7, 1-7, right? Two, the Rashi containing Dhara, Karaka and its seventh house, again axes, right? 3. The Rashi containing Upapada and its 7th house. Do I have to explain what is Upapada? That was the tragedy last year. In June, I taught that class in St. Raphael. And in November, when I was taking the class, I said, when you run into the period of a dasha which is 6th from Upapada, all these researchers give in advanced techniques. I have told you, please tell Rakesh Sharma. The moment that book advanced technique comes, he should give priority to participants here. I don't have more copies. They have not come here yet. They are coming in August or September, I don't know when. He said he wanted them. But we had limited copies, we sent it. I said, don't give it to everyone. Only those who understood Gemini also. You don't waste my book. There you'll come across very fine researches in composite technique. If I have got 50, 60 or 80 books only left alone, who deserves it? You deserve it, not others. So make sure with Rakesh Sharma, you tell him, as soon as that book comes, you have to reserve or copy, if you don't have it. Advanced techniques of astrological prediction, where I'll show you the same event. Yes, that is given there. Last year, I was trying to explain in the day-long class at St. Raphael, this is the period for tension in marriage, this is the period for this, and I made you Upapada. In the audience, some people asked me, what is Upapada? I said, in June, I had taught it to you people. So, it becomes difficult. If I come after 6 months and use a term Upapada, and you say, we have not understood what Mr. Rao has said. I can't help it. You have to remember this. So now you know what is Upapada. Now the importance of 1-7 axis, Lagna 7, Dharakarak 7, Upapada 7, and put in the birth horoscope the Navansha of Dharakaraka. That is Dharakarakansha. I showed you yesterday. Calculate the Chardasha sub-period by sub-period and apply these 5 parameters. The exercise will reveal a wealth of information, good, bad, happy, disastrous, or long and short-term relationships. Now note down where the Rahu Ketu axis falls and which houses they are aspecting. Now the question you asked me today, don't do that again. Never be unhappy about any combinations you see in the horoscope, because there is always a corresponding composition. You are asking a technical question on these lines.
I was trying to think of an example of something.
Right, I'll give you. So, but I found it a very good one. What you asked me, it is not at all bad.
Okay.
Okay. I'm telling you, when you ask me that question, I said, well, anyway, since I'm going to take it up in the class, there I will do it. And naturally, I'll do some mild scolding also. Don't take a pessimistic view. Right? All that Rahu Ketu represents is deviation from the accepted norms, non-conformism. Right? Don't take that horrid picture of Rahu Ketu, demons devouring you all the time. Without the help of Rahu, these people cannot come here to USA and do the work. These Indians sitting here, without the help of Rahu, they cannot come to this country. You have to go to a foreign country and move in a different situation. So what? So don't have that very narrow dogmatic idea. So note down where the Rahu Ketu axis falls and which houses they are aspecting. Similarly, note down the houses being aspected by Dharakaraka. I am taking this, noting down the houses aspected by Dharakaraka mainly because of my experience in USA. And house aspected by Dharakaraka, if you are running into that such a sub-period, depending upon the nature of aspects and other conditions, that is the period when people talk about relationships, they strike relationships. Or they meet with someone with whom they are likely to strike relationships in future. So the houses being aspected by Dharakaraka in that sense become significant. This I added only after my experience in USA. Right? See, if the Putra Karaka falls in the fifth house from a Dasha period. Now, this is one thing which I make use of invariably in the Indian horoscopes of woman. Invariably. Because in India, within 2 years of marriage, they must become mother, a woman. It's a normal traditional society which believes in that. So if the Putra Karaka is falling into the fifth house, she is preparing for motherhood. And in a traditional society, preparing from motherhood means that is marriage followed by motherhood. Yes. And for example, you can see the horoscope of Prince Charles and Diana. Apply the same principles which I have given here. Diana gets married in a period in which Putra Karaka falls in the fifth house. The British biography is about all this. They talk in their normal way, writing about Queen Elizabeth and later also about Prince Diana. Some Englishman wrote a long paragraph. Within 11 months of her birth, Queen Elizabeth became a mother. And within 11 months of her birth, Prince Charles Diana became a mother. And talks as though it was a great world achievement or a world record. Come to India, then they have people breaking only these records. It is nothing. Getting married and having a child within 10 months or 11 months is nothing. It's a very normal thing, even after Orthodox marriage. But they write the long this. But you can see when in the fifth house Putra Karaka is falling, she is preparing for motherhood. Get a hint from here? Now, when I say an astrologer's intellectual equipment, the great Parashara has used a word uha poha patu as one of the necessary qualities of an astrologer, meaning that he should be able to weigh the pros and cons of a situation. Here comes the greatest difficulty. One cannot become a really good astrologer unless one has a sound sociological background of the country which the consultor comes from. During my visit to USA in November 1993, I, as a sportsman, asked the Vedic astrologers whether they had the horoscope of the famous woman tennis player Monica Seles, who had been stabbed in Germany in a tournament. Who is Monica Seles? Most of them asked me. So I put it down on record for your sake. Because I'll keep on accusing you, you have not been able to give me her horoscope even now. Anyway, now skip over case studies. Go to page 62. So, attitude towards marriage, etc., whatever it is, all these things you have to find out. Why, in one place last year, I was accused very badly by a person. He said, you never found out from my horoscope that I was a homosexual. I said, I have not worked on it. In India also we may be having lots of homosexuals. No one would give me his horoscope and tell me he is a homosexual. So how can I have done no research? If I have not found out, it is because I had done no research and no American really has helped me in finding out. And in any case, even if I knew it, perhaps I would never say. But he accused me. You see, understand that? These are the difficulties you have to face. Now, case study number one. In trying to verify the horoscope, as usual, I put some questions about his past without his having to tell me himself. I committed a silly mistake of asking him whether he was married after the age of 20 and before 25. It's a normal thing, isn't it? Between the ages of 20 and 25, I asked him. His answer was married in the womb. He explained that his father had promised his friend whose wife too was pregnant that if their children happened to be of opposite sexes, they would be married. Good friends, they agreed when both their wives were pregnant. She said, what is your date of marriage? He said, I was married before I was born. But the formal marriage took place when he was 12 years old. In 1938, the consummation of marriage took place between 1944 and 46 in the Charadasha of Capricorn, which is aspected by Dara Karak Saturn and is also having the Navansha of Dara Karaka in the 7th house in Cancer. Right? So I am showing you the parameters, but in this case, naturally I committed a serious mistake. What are the date of your marriage? And he said, married before birth. So that is a Rajasthani tradition. Go to the next one. Once bitten, twice shy, I asked another person knowing him to be an Indian of older generation, when child marriages were common, whether he had married early. Now you see, he was married in 1933, when he was running the period of Libra from 1931 to 1940. From Libra, the Navansha of Dara Karaki is in the 7th Aries. Clear? So you can easily locate the period. Dara Karakansha is in the 7th. Incidentally, this horoscope will be useful to you for other types of researches. Also, this is the horoscope of the present President of India, Shankar Dayal Sharma. Yes. Page 63, case number 2. He had, of course, invited me to ask whether, when he was the vice president, whether he could become the president. So I am the only one in the world having his correct horoscope. All other horoscopes of his discussed in astrological are wrong. This is a correct horoscope. Correct to the second. So when you work on this, you can see why in the year 1991, when he had asked me to meet him, I could easily give him a prediction that he was going to become the president. A vital piece of information he had suppressed from me was that he had married second time in 1950. When he was running the period of Sagittarius from 1946 to 52. Someone argued with me that fate governed only fools. I requested him to give me his horoscope and asked him some questions about the past. How did I know it? was his next question. Since he did not believe in fate, instead of asking me how I knew it, would he concede that I had seen astrologically what had happened to him? You see, a wise man will reconcile himself to these things. One of the easiest methods of counseling is, tell a person, look here, accept certain things, as fate accompli, and be still cheerful and pray to God. You remember, how do you pronounce, I don't know, Carl Jung, J-U-N-G, Jung. In one place he wrote, 50 years he worked on patients in hospitals. He said, people who became very old, patients, they always had a lot of fears and troubles. He said, quietly I would go to them, I would get the man alone and ask him, well, what do you think is the most important event awaiting you now? That man would say, death. He said, yes, you know that. And you talk pleasantly and move away. Talk to the second man. Talk to the third man. And slowly tell them, look here, the one thing which is inevitable is death. Jatasya hi dhruvam mrityu. Once you accept that inevitability, bury that fear. And he has recorded. After that, whenever he went and met those patients, he found them absolutely calm and quiet and well collected. Are you becoming a fatalist when you accept the fact that you have to die someday? You are not becoming a fatalist. You are becoming a wise man. So, remember that in counseling, sometimes slowly, mildly, you have to tell a person, well, it is better to live with it instead of trying to run away from it. Cases number 3 and 4. Prince Charles, should I do it or you can do it yourself? Should I explain? In news from some years have been the royal couple of England, Prince Charles and Diana. Their horoscopes are being given for a joint study of the application of the Char Dasha for timing their marriage. Since we know the date, which is July 29th, 1981. One fact you have to remember is, in the case of British monarchy, the marriage is announced at least 1 year before. It's a long preparation, then invitation goes all over. Now, a comparative tabulation of the principles given earlier are, the Dhara Karaka of the prince is the sun in Scorpio. I have marked them in the book. And of Diana, Venus in Taurus. The 1-7 axis of prince is Cancer Capricorn. While of Diana, Sagittarius, Gemini, Lagna in the 7th house. The Upapada of the prince is in Aquarius, while that of Diana is Taurus. Wherever it is not clear, you will please ask me. You are understanding these terms easily now. The Navansha of the DK of the prince is in Cancer, while that of Diana is in Capricorn. The Navansha Lagna of the prince is Libra, while that of Diana is Taurus. The Char Dasha sequence of Prince Charles, 48 to 51, etc., then I go to 79 to 84. No extra deduction for debilitated Venus. Then come to the Capricorn sub-period, 79 to 80, then up to 80, September, Libra, 81, Virgo, July, 81. The marriage of the prince was announced at least 1 year before, but was performed only after the start of the period of Capricorn, which is the 7th house of the horoscope. Is it clear? The marriage was performed in Capricorn, Leo. Here Leo is seventh from the Upupada of the prince which is in Aquarius. So I am taking the 1-7 axis of Lagna, of the Navansha, of the Dharakaraka, of the Upupada. We are getting the parameters. Now apply them. Now what I have found from experience in India and USA is, in India we call Rokini is one word used in northern India. Jocularly I tell them it means booking. When the modern girls come, they don't mind my joking them with a little. Rokini means, now you have, the girl has seen the boy has seen the girl, and they say, all right, we'll marry after 1 year or after 2 years, the boy, let the boy complete his course at Boston, he'll come back and then marry, etc. But 1 year after we'll marry, and only this marriage will take place, this boy will marry this girl. So they go through some ceremony, which they call it Rokini in northern India. And actual marriage may take place after 1 or 2 years. So when these girls come there, I tell them, well, marriages go through 3 stages. Hooking, booking and cooking. So I said, now 3 stages I have to see by applying 3 sub-periods many times. So Rokini is booking, the middle stage. So the Indian father goes on searching boy here and there, you know, all that information. Imagine a man like me coming to USA and some Indian father say, if you find eligible Indian bachelors, please get me a list. I said, look here, I'm not going to do that. Normal thing. So that is the exploratory stage. So this is Rokini means, in India, in USA, that becomes relationship. It is not all relationships that end up in marriage. And it is not all datings that lead to relationships. I last year educated myself by asking some ladies to explain to me what are the difference between dating and marriage. They told me slowly. Yes. I'll tell you, I'll come to that. Upopada is the bed. The analysis of the horoscope Dhyana is now being done in the same way. Sagittarius, Scorpio, Libra, Virgo. Now note, from Virgo in the 5th house, there is Putra Karaka. Right? One of the parameters I have given you. It promises that soon after marriage, Dhyana will become a mother, which she did when her first son was born on June 21, 1982. Again note that in the Vinshottari Dasha, the time of marriage was Rahu Mars. Here in the Navansha, Rahu Ketu axis falls in the Lagna and the 7th house, and the sub period of Mars lasted up to October 19, 1981. In the case of Dhyana, right? You are seeing the Navansha. See, everything is explained here, so I need not wait longer over each case. You can read them. Wherever you have any doubt, you can stop and ask me. Otherwise, I can now skip over. It's enough reading material for you. Now, the question is, why is it a troubled marriage? Keep on doing more research in this area. It is becoming a problem all over the world. In India also, we have a lot of troubled marriages. In USA also, you have a lot of troubled marriages. Dhyana has been running the period of Gemini, the 7th house of our horoscope, since 1988. and it will run up to 2000 AD. It is in this period that her marriage continues to be in trouble. The corresponding dasha in the Vinshottari is Jupiter, debilitated, and Mercury, sub-period which began in 1988. In 1995, the sub-periods are of Mars and later of Rahu. I have given enough hint here. Where is she now? Gone away? Not saying. Ninth house, seventh house, 12th house. I will give you a hint here. I have not given in the book. When there are separations, when you go away, when I was discussing Gochara, most of you should have noticed that I made use of the 12th Lord repeatedly, and I could see that you are not catching what I was hinting at. Actually, in my Gochara lectures, I have given you some richest material not given anywhere. Some of the most unorthodox approaches I make. Some of the boldest predictions I have given. So anyway, go through that Gochara cassette or whatever it is there very carefully. One hint I want to give you here. There are certain things we should not be discussed openly in the class, and certain things you should not also go into the cassette. One has to be careful, because people can misread without understanding and misinterpret, and the knowledge can become dangerous. It can be an abusable knowledge. Since I am doing that, which I do not want to be recorded, for the time being I am keeping it here and explaining. Okay. Now, will you please, the ninth house of this horoscope, at page 65, do you see the ninth horoscope, the horoscope? Which are the planets there?
Mars was 12.
An extension of the principle of classical Parashara. The day you have forgotten the classical principle of Parashara, your astrology is doomed. In my book Ups and Downs, I talked about CRF, classical, romantic, and formula. So take the classical principle. Now innovate and improvise. Fifth house is the house of Purva Punya, that is the spiritual merit of past life. And ninth house is the house of this Janma Punya, spiritual merit of this life. And I am today on a very, very strong ground to establish this. Some astrologers in India say, no, ninth house represents Puru Janma Punya. Now that question doesn't arise. When I present my paper on astrology and reincarnation, I will prove the point. Someday, I will write out that also. I have told you already, I have made a major breakthrough. I have 10 cases of 5 persons with 2 horoscopes, each of that person, one of the previous life, one of the present life, authenticated details with authentic horoscopes. It has opened up a totally new vista for me. And once I present it to you, you will see why you must take only an optimistic view of life.
How do you know that the
those horoscopes of the previous life on the
stage. You must take only a hopeful view of life. You keep on evolving into a higher being. Every day should be a rosy day, because you can keep on unfolding spiritually more and more. So never be hopeless. Astrology has always a message of hope to give to you. And the day I complete that paper on astrology and reincarnation, I will perhaps have awakened in every intelligent man the feeling that the past has always to be dead and the future can always be beautiful. If astrology cannot deliver that message, my lifetime work and research in astrology will be wasted. So remember, now come back, 9th house. Therefore, Puru Janma Punya and this Janma Punya also show orthodoxy and unorthodoxy. You understand? Orthodox, unorthodox. Conformist, non-conformist. In the 9th house, when you have Mars and Rahu, you know, under the British Convention, the would-be king would marry only a virgin. And therefore, right from the start, some such girl in England historically has always been singled out, earmarked. But even after such a marriage, fulfilling all that conditions, why is it that there has been such an extreme and wild swing to the sacrosanct? Prince Charles has been running the Dasha of Sagittarius since 1986, the Dasha of 6th House of Disputes, page 67, last paragraph. Page 67, last paragraph, which will be over in 1998. In Vinshottari, this will be the period of Rahu and sub-period of Jupiter. That is the period to be watched for the much awaited upward swing in the life of the prince. But there will still be no hope of marital tangle getting resolved. Through Vinshottari Dasha and Dishchar Dasha, you don't see any hope of this marriage getting resolved. But there is a hope in the other direction of succeeding the queen. Now go to the other question, marriage related parts. Now from here onwards, what I gave here with some notes edited is what I wrote in 1991 or 92 in the astrological magazine. I published my researches there, hoping, inviting attacks on me by all Gemini scholars for the revolutionary departures I have made, for the meanings I have put on different karakas, for the calculation I have given to the Chardasha. Not one person anywhere in India attacked me. But everyone behind my back keeps on criticizing me. I said, look here, I produce a technical paper. You should attack me technically. That is all. Then both of us enrich our knowledge. Medical science has progressed because of this. Any science in the world is progressing because of this. I am producing technical papers, cases, where I have given prediction in advance, later turned them into case studies. So, I can continue with this marriage related problems, or do you want to continue after filling your stomach? I don't know. Look at the watch, clock, and tell me, what should I do? Pardon?
How long would you take? So we'll be back at 2:30.